Jesus is my Lord. God raised him from the dead. He was my substitute. He is my Savior. Satan has no power over me. Jesus is my Lord. I serve the one whose name is. I am the Lord who heals you. Jesus is the healer. Satan is the oppressor. For Acts 10:38 says, God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed by the devil. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Jesus came that I may have life and have it in its fullness. God desires that I prosper and be in health. My God is supplying all I need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. The Lord is my helper. I will not be afraid. God says in his word in Joel 3:10, let the weak say, I am strong. I am strong in the Lord. God says in his word in Isaiah 33:24, the inhabitant will not say, I am sick. Therefore, I will not say it. I will say what God has said in his word. By his wounds, I have been healed. 1 Peter 2:24. Jesus says in Mark 11:23, whoever says to this mountain, be removed and be cast into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that those things he says will come to pass, he will have whatever he says. Therefore, mountain of sickness, be removed from me and be cast into the sea. You have to, because I command it in the authority of Jesus' name. According to Jesus, since I do not doubt in my heart, but I believe those things I say will come to pass, I will have what I say. Therefore, by faith, I will say these confessions. Hebrews 3:1, 4:14 say Jesus is the high priest of my confession. So I will only speak words that I desire Jesus to say about me. Death and life are in the power of the tongue. Therefore, I will speak words of life. Jesus says in John 6:63 that his words are life, so I will speak them. Proverbs 18:21. When I speak God's word, I am planting good seed in my life. Luke 8:11. I will hold fast to the confession of God's word without wavering, for he who promised is faithful. I do not waver at the promise of God through unbelief, but I am fully convinced that what he has promised, he is also able to perform. I am not weak in faith, so I do not consider my own body above what God has said. I do not put my confidence in flesh. I am not moved by what I feel. I'm not moved by what I see, for I walk by faith, not by sight. I'm moved only by what I believe. I believe the word of God. Father, your word is truth. I will give attention to God's words. I will incline my ear to his sayings. I will not let them depart from my eyes. I will keep them in my heart. They are life to me, for I have found them, and they are my health, healing, and medicine to all my flesh. Pleasant words are health, healing, and medicine to my bones. God's word of grace builds me up and gives me my inheritance. Jesus says, if I continue in his word, I will know the truth, and the truth will make me free. I have been called to freedom. Because I am Christ's, I am a child of Abraham. And according to Jesus in Luke 13 and 16, I ought to be loosed from all bondage today because God shows no partiality. I am God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus. I am a new creation in Christ Jesus. Old things have passed away. All things have become new, and all things are of God. I am complete in Jesus, who is the head of all rule and authority. My body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, who is in me, and I am not my own. I am bought at a price, so I will glorify God in my body and in my spirit. I present my body to God as a living sacrifice. Christ has redeemed me from the curse of the law. Therefore, no sickness, illness, virus, or disease can stay in my body. Every disease, germ, and virus that touches my body dies instantly. Every cell, organ, member, and system of my body functions perfectly, and I forbid any malfunction in the supreme authority of the name of Jesus. I am a believer. All things are possible to me. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. The Lord is the strength of my life. I am strong in the Lord and in His mighty power. Hallelujah. Greater is He that is in me than he that is in the world. My Father has made me able to be a partaker of my inheritance. He has delivered me from the authority of darkness and has translated me into the kingdom of His dear Son, in whom I have my redemption through His blood. I am an overcomer, and I overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of my testimony. I am submitted to God by being submitted to His word, and the devil flees from me because I resist him in the supreme authority of the name of Jesus. No weapon formed against me shall prosper, for my righteousness is of the Lord. There shall nothing evil happen to me, neither shall any plague or sickness come near me. Jesus gave me authority over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall hurt me. I do not return evil for evil, but on the contrary, blessings, that I may obtain a blessing. I forgive others freely as God has forgiven me. I don't hold anything against anyone. I refrain my tongue from evil. I turn away from evil and do good. I seek peace and pursue it. So I will love life and see good days. I have a merry heart, and that does me good like medicine. I have cast all my cares on the Lord, for He cares for me. I refuse to worry about anything. I serve the Lord my God, and He blesses my bread and my water, and He has taken sickness away from me. For Jesus Himself took my infirmities and bare my sicknesses away. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Surely He has borne my sicknesses and carried my pains. Yet we did esteem Him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. But He was wounded for my transgressions. He was bruised for my iniquities. The chastisement for my peace was upon Him, and by His stripes I am healed. Christ, my Passover, was sacrificed for me. So all sickness and death has to pass over me and my household. I am blessed above all people. The Lord has taken away from me all sickness. God sent His word and healed me and delivered me from destruction. The number of my days God will fulfill. Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Matthew 8:1-3. And having come down from the mountain, great crowds followed Jesus. And behold, a leper, having come, fell upon his knees and touched the ground with his forehead in an expression of profound reverence before him, saying, Master, in the event that you may be having a heartfelt desire, I know you're able to cleanse me. And having stretched out his hand, Jesus touched him, saying, I am desiring it with all my heart. Be cleansed at once. And immediately his leprosy was cured by being cleansed away. Healing is not just an afterthought for the Lord. He is desiring to heal you with all his heart. Today we're the same as this leper, saying, Lord, I know you can heal me if you want to, but do you really want to? He is wanting to heal you with all his heart. God wants to heal everyone, just as he desires all men to be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth. Father, you have said, listen closely to your words, not to let them out of my sight, not for a moment, to keep them within my heart, because they are life when I find them and health to my whole body. This is my comfort in my affliction, for your word has given me life. You will bring me health and cure, and will cure me, and will reveal unto me the abundance of peace and truth. Is not your word like a fire, and like a hammer that breaks the rock in pieces? The word of God is an all-consuming fire that will melt away and burn off that which is not of God. It is a powerful, crushing force to break apart even the toughest and most stubborn sickness. Why are you cast down, O my soul? And why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for you will yet praise him who is the health of your countenance and your God. The Lord is good, a stronghold in the day of trouble, and he knows those who trust in him. He will make an utter end of this sickness. Now this is the confidence that I have in him, that if I ask anything according to his will, he hears me. And if I know that he hears me, whatever I ask, I know that I have the petitions that I've asked of him. I can declare a thing and it will be established for me, and light will shine on my path. My Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth and in my life and in my body as it is in heaven. I declare that in all respects I will prosper and be in health, just as my soul prospers. I will not die, but live to declare the works of the Lord. Lord, strengthen the hands that hang down and the feeble knees, and make straight paths for my feet, so that what is lame may not be dislocated, but rather healed. Father, you did not spare your own son, but delivered him up for us all. How shall you not freely with him give me all things? Lord, if you are with me, who can be against me? You do not change, therefore I am not consumed. Thank you, Lord. Lord, I'm not going to fear because I know you are with me. I'm not dismayed, for I know you're my God and that you will strengthen me. Yes, you will help me and uphold me with the right hand of your righteousness. If the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in me, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to my mortal body through his spirit who dwells in me. Lord, you take away all my sickness and will not afflict me with any of the terrible diseases of Egypt, which you have known, but will lay them on all those who hate me. If I diligently heed the voice of the Lord my God, and do what is right in his sight, and I give ear to his commandments, and keep all his statutes, you will put none of the diseases on me, which were brought on the Egyptians. For you are the Lord who heals me. You will restore health to me and heal all my wounds. You forgive all my iniquities and you heal all my diseases. My light shall break forth like the morning. My healing shall spring forth speedily. My righteousness shall go before me. The glory of the Lord shall be my rear guard. God, you are not a man that you should lie, nor the son of man that you should repent. Have you not said, and will you not do? Or have you spoken, and will you not make it good? For the eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth to show himself strong on behalf of those whose heart is loyal to him. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. I shall not want for healing. O Lord, my God, I've cried out to you, and you healed me. Lord, you will strengthen me on my bed of illness. You will sustain me on my sick bed. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but Lord, you deliver me out of them all. If I then, being evil, know how to give good gifts to my children, how much more will my heavenly Father, who is in heaven, give good things to me because I ask him? Surely you have borne my griefs and carried my sorrows. Yet I esteemed you stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. But you were wounded for my transgressions. You were bruised for my iniquities. The chastisement of my peace was upon you. And by your stripes I was healed. Let it be fulfilled which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, he himself took my infirmities and bore my sicknesses. He himself bore my sins in his body on the tree, that I, having died to sins, might live for righteousness, by whose stripes I was healed. Because I know your name, I will put my trust in you, for you, Lord, have not forsaken me when I seek you. I will not forget your law, and my heart will keep your commandments. For length of days and long life and peace they will add to me. Because I wait on the Lord, I will renew my strength. I will mount up with wings like eagles. I will run and not be weary, and I will walk and not faint. To those who fear your name, the Son of Righteousness shall arise with healing in his wings, and I shall go out and grow fat like stall-fed calves. Lord, you have highly exalted Jesus and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of things in heaven, of those on the earth, and of those under the earth. And in that day you will ask me nothing. Most assuredly, I say to you, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. And whatever you ask in my name, that I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask me anything in my name, I will do it. Jesus said, if you can believe, all things are possible to him who believes. Jesus, I believe. I thank you that all things are possible for me. I have faith in you, my God. Because I have faith, whatever things I ask when I pray, believing, I will receive them. I will not waver at the promise of God through unbelief, but I will be strengthened in faith, giving glory to God, and being fully convinced that what he has promised, he is also able to perform. Lord, you are able. Because I am born of God, I overcome the world. And this is the victory that has overcome the world, my faith. I am of God and have overcome because he who is in me is greater than he who is in the world. For it is God who works in me, both to will and to do of his good pleasure. Therefore, I submit to you, God. I resist the devil, and he will flee from me. Devil, I command you to go from me in the name of Jesus. I command all sickness and infirmity to go from me in the name of Jesus. Jesus, I abide in you, and your words abide in me. Therefore, I can ask whatever I desire, and it shall be done for me. I hold fast the confession of my hope without wavering, for you have promised, and Lord, you are faithful. Jesus, you said, have faith in God, that I can speak to the mountain and speak to this sickness and say, be removed, be cast into the sea. I do not doubt in my heart, but I believe that the things that I say will be done, and that I will have whatever I say. I bless you, Lord, with all my soul. I forget not any of your benefits. I thank you that you forgive all my iniquities, that you heal all my diseases, that you have redeemed my life from destruction. You crown my life with loving kindness and tender mercies. You satisfy my mouth with every good thing, so that my youth is renewed like the eagles. So shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the thing for which I sent it. I declare that I am healed by the stripes of Jesus. Jesus carried my sickness and infirmities, and I cast out all spirits of infirmity that would attach to my body in the name of Jesus. I break all curses of premature death and destruction in the name of Jesus. I command every part of my body to function the way God intended it. My bones are fat because they receive the good report of the gospel. and I release the fire of God to burn out any sickness or disease that would operate in my body in the name of Jesus. For the Lord is the strength of my life, and Jesus Christ makes me whole. I am redeemed from sickness and disease. May the Lord Jesus Christ arise over my life with healing in his wings. The blood of Jesus bears witness with my deliverance, my healing, and my salvation. I receive the benefits of the new covenant through the blood of Jesus. I receive healing and health through the blood of Jesus. Jesus resisted unto blood, and his blood gives me the victory. And by his stripes, I was healed.
The Son of Righteousness arise with healing in his wings. Heart disease, lung disease, cholera, rheumatic disease, tuberculosis, strep throat, malaria, leprosy, digestive disorders, intestinal disorders, fibrocystic breast disease, childbearing difficulties, toxic shock syndrome, hepatitis, measles, chickenpox, bronchitis, emphysema, osteoporosis, Parkinson's disease, gallbladder disease, influenza, encephalitis, smallpox, dysentery, thrombosis, angina, mumps, hypoglycemia, diabetes, brain and neurological disorders, rabies, rubella, kidney and bladder disease, liver disease, pancreatic disease, lupus, bone and joint disease, plague, whooping cough, endometriosis, progeria, tumors, glandular disorders, Lyme disease, Crohn's disease, hypertension, parasites, viruses, cerebral palsy, multiple sclerosis, mental illness, ulcers, Alzheimer's, blood disease, depression, PMS, malnutrition, pellagra, rickets, scurvy, back pain, bursitis, tetanus, phlebitis, bacterial disease, inflammations, genetic and birth defects, cystic fibrosis, migraines, burns, muscle and skin disease, gynecological disorders, gum disease, Hodgkin's disease, Lou Gehrig's disease, colitis, epidemics, anemia, allergies, fever, headaches, SIDS, arthritis, psoriasis, leukemia, all curses, cancer, all infections, all addictions, all injuries, AIDS, sexually transmitted disease, pneumonia, cirrhosis, bacterial meningitis, muscular dystrophy, blindness and eye disease, poisoning, spider and serpent bites, and scorpion stings. I am the Lord that healeth thee. Jesus took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. And by his stripes, we were healed.
Everybody
say amen.
God
has spoken.
So
let the church
say
amen.
Yeah. Can I get a witness?
Let the church
say
amen
to what is his plans are.
Let the church
to what his word
said.
God has spoken.
God has spoken.
Let the church. From the healing of your body,
amen,
to the raising of the dead,
amen,
no matter how you're feeling,
amen,
or how your world is reeling,
amen,
battle on through the night,
amen,
'cause you're gonna win the fight,
amen,
even in the valley,
amen,
or standing at your Red Sea,
amen,
continue to say,
amen,
'cause your help. Let the church say, oh, 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 lift your hands wherever you are and let the church. Believers say, hey.